Welcome back, baseball fans, to the Fall Carryover League 69, 70, 71, 72. This is time for Hot Stove Talk number 2. In Hot Stove Talk number 1, we discussed Frank Howard in what could be a dream Weaver list. Probably not going to happen, but we tossed out 3 teams. Interested. We're going to keep the subject matter again very similar. It's going to involve a guy who traveled into the league. It's going to happen to involve a guy who batted the same way and played the same position, had the same kind of defense, power, walks, strikeouts. The only difference is speed. And I'm going to go to our guy who's worth a long chat anyway. He's worth his own video. We're going to go to Philadelphia. And we're going to go to Rick Dick Allen. So he's the dude tonight on the talk. Let me zoom over a little bit. And Dick Allen is the subject. I'm going to put on the screen because I can't do live video and the reference at the same time. These are screen captures. First screen capture is the movement of Dick Allen from 1969 to 1972. And this is the the time of the Courier Carryover League. So this incredible card, which is, 288 hitting card with a ton of OPS, power, homer, walks, and he's a beast stealer. Can't play first very well. He's a 40-25. He can't play the outfield. But you see the movement. At the end of this 69 season, he will leave Philadelphia with Jerry Johnson, and we'll go to St. Louis for Byron Brown, Curt Flood, Joe Horner, and Tim McCarver. Note that Curt Flood refused to report to his new team. But it's funny part about this is, I'm going to make Curt Flood report to the Phillies in a separate trade, straight up for Rick Wise. And then there were other players added to the trade later, Montanez and Browning. Then almost a year to the day, October 5th, 1970, he was traded on October 7th, 69. Almost a year to the day, the Cardinals said, you know what, let's get Ted Sizemore. And they decided to trade Dick Allen straight up for Ted Sizemore because Bob Stinson was a minor leaguer. Then the following year, after playing a year in L.A., mind you, he's played a 69 in Philadelphia, 70 in St. Louis, and 71 he played with the Dodgers. At the end of that year, the Dodgers said, you know what? Hey, White Sox, how about you give us Tommy John for him? And another guy, Steve Hunt. So they did. And then he went to the White Sox for the 72 season and proceeded to win the America League Most Valuable Player Award. So this guy is probably the most hot stovish of all players during this timeline. Just to go through, as we look again through the OPS, when you consider his MVP season in the American League, it was 1,023. You go back 3 years prior to this Philadelphia card, it's 949. And really, they're pretty darn close. You know, they're pretty reasonable. The average is slightly better, and that translates to a higher OPS, which translates to on base. Every stat goes up about 20 points or so. Overall OPS is up 73 points, but it's already high anyway. All right, so let's get back to looking at the card here. Dick Allen. Now, you look at him and it's like, well, he's really DH only, or first base. He can't even play the outfield, which would be nice. And he can't play second base here, which he could play at certain points in time. So right now, he should finish this year for the Phillies, unless we have something up our sleeve. So let's contemplate, at least for 5 minutes, this notion of him going to the St. Louis Cardinals. And believe me, Philadelphia and St. Louis aren't exactly fond of each other as trade partners, based on all I had to do to get compensation to the Cardinals for Steve Carlton, and then the Curt Flood, Rick Wise trade. But let's just see if there's even an opening on St. Louis. They have Simmons, Duncan. Torre will be upgraded to his 71 card, and he'll be a third baseman. So that means that right now, Simmons, Duncan, Javier, Torre, Brock, Cardinal, Berta would be the guy tossed in. A 296 hitting one-way platoon guy. So he'd be half of the trade. And the other half of the trade might be, well, this guy, Sudeikis. So if you're looking at these two together, it's a small sample size. They have 14 homers and 300 at-bats, which prorates to 30 homers and a 280, 290. At that point, the Phillies are probably going, why would we want to do that? You know, let's just keep Dick Allen, unless we simply don't need his right-handed bat. And after looking at it, I think the Cardinals might say, you know what, let's just put Bob Berta and Bill Sudeikis at first base and find an outfielder. And then as far as the pitching goes with the Cardinals, they got a rotation that they're happy with. The only possible guy to move would be Chuck Taylor, because you know they're going to keep Gibson. Holtzman was the compensation for Carlton, and they just got Rick Wise in the trade for Flood. So, and actually, Wise actually purchased pretty well. I know that seemed like a lopsided trade for Carlton, but he has a couple of nice years in there. So I'm looking at St. Louis, and I'm thumbing my nose to this. And moving on, well, let's think about the Dodgers. Now, I don't know why the Dodgers would have done this anyway. I guess they didn't have a lot of... I guess Wes Parker was probably fading sooner than expected. Guys like Bill Buckner and Steve Garvey weren't ready yet. They're a couple years away from making it. But at least for now, they still have Wes Parker. And they're going to have the 72 Bill Buckner card. And frankly, they're going to be loaded as far as pitching goes. And you know what? They're not going to mess up what they got in L.A. They've made a lot of deals in the offseason to get a really great pitching staff that's going to be together for a long time. And I don't think they're going to mess it up. Particularly, it seems like the Dodgers were... And they also, the Dodgers, what they also did, they traded for Frank Robinson, and they had him for 1 year. So anytime you see a all-star on a team for 1 year, it raises some eyeballs, I think. So let's go to team three, which is the White Sox. Now, White Sox were pretty clever earlier in the trade season when they said, you know what? We have a funny feeling we're not going to get Dick Allen till 72. But we have a gaping hole at first base. So they engineered a three-team deal, but they traded away through a three-team proxy, Tommy John. So they actually got Tommy John to the Dodgers. The Dodgers sent a great 72 Dusty Baker to the Braves. But the Braves sent to the White Sox this guy, Orlando Cepeda. And that's who they're sitting at right now. And they have his card for 2 more years. So if you're sitting with this and you're thinking about this, you're like, oh, wait a minute. He's a 2E13 at first base, and the dude hit 34 homers and hit 305. Again, I don't know why I would want this guy, at least not yet. I'd only be interested in Dick Allen once Cepeda was done and moved on after 2 more years. So again, this is really leaning heavily to the Phillies. I'm not going to say being stuck with them because they're not, but for this really to just to play out where the Phillies keep him on the team through the end of 69. And then in the offseason, he can be a keeper and be a keep and trade. And maybe they get Orlando Cepeda, the Phillies do, from the White Sox, or the White Sox put Allen at first base. The only problem, if you look at the rest of the Phillies, you got this guy playing first base, Darren Johnson. So they really don't even need a first baseman. They have Dick Allen, who's at this point a DH. DH, catcher, first, second, third, short. They have a couple outfielders. Lozinski will join them soon. Pitching's, you know, they're going to have Carlton, Grant Jackson, and... So I'm not exactly sure. It would have to be a 69-69 deal. A player, another 1969 player traded straight up for Dick Allen. And the only area that I think the Phils would entertain improvement is if you consider that at second, third, and short, you're kind of stuck there. You don't have Schmidt yet, of course. Mike Schmidt's not ready. But you have Tony Taylor as a nice card. And Boa, of course, has great defense. And then you have Terry Harmon as the middle guy. So, and Taylor's versatile enough to play second or third. So you could theoretically trade for a second or third baseman, or you could line yourself up for a left fielder to join Flood and Callison. That's the candidates for Philadelphia. And trying to find maybe another partner in each league and for Dick Allen that we don't otherwise know of, who has playoff aspirations. We mentioned Minnesota and the Mets earlier. Would the Mets consider doing it? He'd be a little bit cheaper than Frank Howard, right? But they'd probably trade Clendenon, right? They have Seaver, Kuzma, McGraw. Clendenon 70 card, so a team would go, we get Clendenon for 2 years, while the Mets get Dick Allen for 1 year. Again, that's two sideways of a deal. I think the Mets would stand pat. Let's look at other first basemen. Baltimore, Boog Powell. Here's a team, Cincinnati. They don't have, well, they have Lee May still, right? Yeah, they got Lee May, so they're not interested. You got Willie McCovey here. Oakland's got Tennis, Rudy has to play. Well, Rudy could move to the outfield. So Oakland would be a possibility. Because Rudy has to move to the outfield where Ricky Henderson played last year. Right? Because they have pretty weak outfield to the A's. Tennis catches. Let's say Rudy is now a left fielder. But that, and then you ask the question, well, what do you get, what do you, you know, and Dick Allen would be a perfect Oakland A, wouldn't he? I mean, he looks just like Gene Tennis, right? And he, you know, all these guys are homer, walk, and strike out. But actually, when you go through this roster, they're all homegrown Oakland players. Yeah. So a pitcher would make some sense. Blue, Hunter. This guy would be the odd man out. They don't really need Mike Torres and Jim Nash. I don't know if they're good enough to get, be dealt. Locker is a good reliever. They're not going to get rid of Blue or Catfish Hunter, and they're going to have. But I could see Torres or Nash. I'm not just sure that Oakland's a great trade partner either. But that would be kind of fun. We talked Detroit. Colorado, we're going to add Dave Kingman to that team. The Twins are going to have Killebrew. We talked about the Dodgers. And, of course, Frank Howard's here. And Atlanta, in the deal I got, they unloaded Cepeda in, they're actually going to be, interestingly, they're going to have Gale Hopkins be part of a first base platoon. And believe it or not, if they upgrade, well, Hank Aaron can play first against some lefties. And his defense is the same bad defense Dick Allen has. The Cubs at first base, they should have Ernie Banks as a righty, and they don't have a lefty. Bob Oliver is on Kansas City. I don't think Kansas City wants to do any trading. They're pretty much bring up guys through their own system. Ohio players, this could be an interesting player in this. But Ike Brown is a right-handed. Ike Brown sort of solves the Dick Allen roll. Look at the homers and walks and his defense. But he can also play second and third. Cash can play second. and you already have a couple third basemen and a shortstop, plus Chuck Hinton's first in the outfield. Kind of a logjam here. Yeah, I don't know who they would take. If they wanted to take Lou Klimchuk off your hands, but again, I mean, he's good against righties, still crappy on defense. So here's a start. You would say, okay, Philly, we'll give you Lou Klimchuk. That gives you the batting average and half a player. Now we got to give you the other half of a player. Maybe the other half of a player is a great pitcher. They got three great lefties here. But Philadelphia has three left-handed relievers already. They are lefties. They have Carlton. They have Grant Jackson.
Ooh.
And they have Joe Horner. Well, Tom Hall is outstanding. Tom Hall's a 70 player. Grant Jackson was a 70 player. I think I could see a 2-for-2 move. Let's go see where Grant Jackson is. Is he a 70 player or not? Grant Jackson, 69 player. So you kind of have to make the deals match unless you find a third team as a proxy. So it doesn't seem like Ohio's got enough ammunition. They're close, but probably not. And then from here, we're going to get into the middle of the pack. Houston will have Bob Watson, a young Bob Watson. Cleveland has Tony Horton, who's a nice first baseman. 27 homers and a .278 batting average. And the Pirates are going to have Stargell. We talked about the Mets. The Red Sox have Yastrzemski. The Yankees are going to sign Danny Cater. Portland just traded for Rich Reese. Seattle, expansion team. Well, Pepitone can play first. Yeah, this has all the earmarks of, in the hot stove talk, that the White Sox are determined to wait a couple years and make the deal. And it's all because they made that deal for Orlando Cepeda. Could Arizona try and steal the Mountain Time Zone division away from the Colorado Rockies? Now, they certainly have a lot of interesting guys here. Check this guy out. .343 batting average as a fringe player, but he could play third, and the Phillies don't have a third baseman yet. That's a 70 card, though. Now you got to find a 69 and a 70 together. Probably throw a pitcher in here. Dave Boswell, 20-game winner Dave Boswell with the Minnesota Twins, just sitting there doing nothing. Well, I think the Phillies would say, look, yeah, we have to put Thomas in the trade. Thomas and somebody for Dick Allen and somebody. Then Philadelphia, now the Phillies would have a good infield because they'd have Darren Johnson at first, Tony Taylor, Larry Bowe at second and short, and this George Thomas guy at third. So the strategy is, why would the Arizona Diamondbacks do this? It's because they play in the division that one of the four expansion teams makes the playoffs every year, and maybe the Diamondbacks are making the move for Dick Allen to leap over the Colorado Rockies, win the division in the present year. I don't think Toronto has they have a great first baseman already from 69 with .348 and a limited sample size. The Expos, yeah, we're getting to the point here where these teams would be just not having the right mix. Which leaves only, possibly, the team with the first overall pick of the draft. Okay, the California, we're going to check this out. So we know the California Angels are doing some moves. They did a move to get Nolan Ryan on the team, move Messersmith, get Bill Singer on the team. Their first baseman is Jim Spencer, who obviously is a defensive first baseman, which makes a Dick Allen signing, DH only. Right now, you got Etchebarren and Roof can catch. Spencer at first, Alomar at second. You got a shortstop. Alex Johnson was kind of your DH last year because he can't play left field very well, but frankly, you could just make him play left field. with his 649 plate appearances before there was a DH in 1970. So he did play left field. You got John Stone, find a right fielder. Okay, so could it work for the Angels? Like I said, they could sneak into a wild card discussion. The worst team in baseball in the previous summer league. And that's where you kind of like, they can have a killer draft. We know about the pitching is going to be really good, but they need one more big bat to scare everybody. Plus, they traded away Jim Fregosi to get Mari Wills. So is it, if it's Dick Allen looking for a 69 guy to get rid of, and frankly, you know, their center fielder, Jay Johnston, well, I wouldn't want to trade him for many reasons. First of all, the Phillies have Kurt Flood now in a trade, so they don't really need Johnston. Johnston would play eventually for the Phillies, so, interesting. But there's no stopping the Phillies from putting Flood in center field and putting Johnston in left field until, you know, and then they have Jay Johnston in Philadelphia for a while. This would make the defense for this team pretty bad. And can you really justify Jay Johnston straight up for Dick Allen? Now, Jay Johnston led the Angels in hitting this year, but he only had 10 home runs and hit 270. So it doesn't make a lot of sense. Philly's going to need more than that. And as far as this team giving up, you know, extra dudes, Jim McLaughlin wouldn't necessarily be needed because they're going to have Ryan Singer and draft Clyde Wright. This is a pretty good Jim McLaughlin card. The win-loss is bad, but the ERA is nice, and he pitches on the rotation. He's also a 69 player. The advantage of trading the players in the first year of a contract, first year of the carryover league, is that whether it's a good trade or bad trade, you only get the one season out of it, and then you can make corrections moving forward. How about this guy coming out of their bullpen? Wilhelm going to Philadelphia, that'd be nice. And then you have lights out closer Ken Tatum, who's two-time All-Star. Now we're talking. And then you have Garrett from 70. So if the Phillies get on the phone and say, I kind of like it. I like the idea of John Stone and some of this pitching going to Philadelphia for Dick Allen. And then the Angels simply have to make sure that they don't lose too much pitching and put some defense in the outfield in center and right field. And they could be a surprise wildcard team. So that's it tonight. Hot stove talk number 2. If there's any other players from this era that you think would make a good hot stove discussion, put it in the comment section, and we'll see if I can make a kind of video for that. Thanks for checking out these videos. We'll see you next time.